performers and other audience members, we ask your cooperation. Please make sure that all electronic devices, such as cell phones, beepers, and watch chimes, are turned to their silent mode. Should it be necessary for you to leave the hall, please do so only at the completion of the musical number during the applause. Food, drinks, cameras, and recording devices of any kind are not allowed in the hall. Thank you for your cooperation and enjoy the performance.
Thank you. Thank you. you all for coming, the three of you in the audience and everyone watching on the live stream. thank you all so much for your support. It's been a very strange semester, but I wouldn't have made it through without all of you. Thank you so much to my pianist, Amanda Sherrill, for working with me to put together this recital. And thank you to Dr. John Erickson for guiding me along the way. And of course, thank you to my parents for their lifelong support. And finally, thank you to my wife, Kendra, for all of her love and encouragement, and for agreeing to let me turn our house into a practice studio for the past 8 months. So when I started my doctorate, I made a commitment to play at least one new work by a living composer on each of my recitals. So this evening we're going to bring you the Prague Sonata by Elizabeth R. Austin, who happens to be watching on the live stream this evening. thankfully, we had the pleasure of being able to speak with Mrs. Austin and get some feedback on her composition and how we should perform it. And thankfully, she also left us very detailed program notes about the piece. So the Prague Sonata doesn't refer to a sonata just limited to a one-form movement. It is meant to refer to a development over all three movements of this piece. So in sonata fashion, there are contrasts between opposites. In this case, tonal with non-tonal elements, musical quotation with newly composed material, and textural difference between horn and piano, and chronological metrical time as opposed to flowing outside of time. The first movement is based around the motives of Mozart's Prague Symphony, and the rhythmic instability within the movement will become apparent as with its connection to Mozart, and the contrasting attitudes presented by the horn and the piano. It will end with a quotation from Dvorak's New World Symphony, leading us into uncharted territory of the second movement or development of the sonata. The image here is of light streaming outside of linear time in a timeless space between past and future. The horn and the piano kind of go off on their separate journeys, only occasionally acknowledging each other. And finally, the last movement, called Villanelle, is a recapitulation of all of these kind of concepts, and is named after the 16th century poetic form of villanelle, which alternates two main ideas in strophic form. So when a typical recapitulation unites themes, this one combines the themes and juxtaposes them sharply, creating the feeling of two realities. So without further ado, thank you to Elizabeth R. Austin for watching tonight, for composing this lovely piece. We'll bring you the Prague Sonata. Thank you.
around